Well, how you doing, ladies and gentlemen? Greetings and welcome. So let's go ahead and let's talk about to SLI or not to SLI. So I recently decided I was going to experiment with using NVIDIA SLI on this new editing rig that I'm building, and we got it built. It's running. I'm recording this video on it. I'm talking with a new microphone. We're going to try some new things with this mic. I do have an amplifier we're going to be plugging into this microphone eventually. So what I ended up with was I bought two 1070s in a package deal. Now, you have to remember, okay, for the games that I run, the 1070 does just fine. I mean, I don't run a lot of high-end AAA BS on my computers. I'm not that type of gamer. That's not what I do. I run basic things, you know, Minecraft. I can run the park, the forest, you know, things that I normally play that will run on any graphics processor out there. But I decided, okay, I'm going to try to SLI two 1070s together. Was it a good idea? Hell no. And I don't recommend fooling around with it. And I'll explain where I got absolutely screwed in messing around with this. First off, I bought two identical 1070s. They're identical on the outside, but not identical on their firmware. This is going to come up later on because this becomes a big problem when doing SLI. Are you ready? Let's begin. I went on, you know, my local cheat sheet sites to find two 1070s that were identical. You know, you're going to find them, the GTX 1070. You find them everywhere, you know, not a big deal. I went and I got the bridge. You've seen one bridge, you've seen them all. I have plenty of power to handle it. New 1,000-plus watt power supply. No issues there. I decided, okay, I'm going to SLI these two cards together. The drivers picked it up. I can turn SLI on. And every single time I tried to run anything, it would black screen of death and crash. No matter what I tried. Now, I know both cards work. I've tested them separately. What I figured out was both of them have different firmwares. Yeah, and this is where things get weird. I decided, okay, I'm going to then take the firmware off of one working card and flash it to the other card. Since they're identical cards, I should be able to pull the firmware off of one card and flash it to the other. And the other card in my machine looks exactly like this, 100%. Turns out, no, I was wrong. Turns out that the firmware is different on both of them. And that's where I ran into the problem of doing SLI. Because they were different firmwares, they behaved differently. So, it's not going to work. I tried. Not going to argue, you know, remember, experimentation. Try new things. Try some amazing new things. Well, I tried. We failed. Ta-da. Problem solved. This is where it got scary. I go back to the single 1070, and I have no audio coming out of the card. Now, for people who don't understand, I do not have a set of Sound Blaster speakers connected to my computers. I run all of my sound through the graphics card's HDMI port to an LG ultra-wide monitor on purpose because the ultra-wides work good for video editing, screen editing. When you need to go across an entire video, you can do so. Correct. Wonderful idea. Great for editing, great for photo editing, you know, things that I do in my life. Well, out of flipping nowhere, I'm getting no audio. And the first thing I immediately thought was, oh, fudge, I burned out the audio pass-through by connecting the two cards in SLI. Close. I burned out the audio pass-through through only one card. Not the card I'm using. Thank the Lord. What happened was is this secondary bugger with a different firmware also seems to have some weird audio core issue. And basically it didn't like the audio core that the first card was using and basically deleted itself out of existence on this card. So this thing is now a pile of Retrosputum junk. Because you will never get audio out of this again, and you will probably not get any video out of this one after the crap that happened with the secondary card. So I am like, okay, I am glad and grateful that I experimented, but I will never do that again, and I will never run another SLI rig as long as I freaking live. Not with that big of a danger coming to almost blowing up the audio channels on my new computer. No, thank you. No way in hell, and you can go jump off a bridge. So I decided, okay, back to one card. I am so grateful that the community has DDU. The PC community. If you're not familiar with DDU, it's the driver uninstaller, and it's by guru3d.com. It's called DDU. It's desktop driver uninstaller, and what it does is it uninstalls the GPU driver when you're having problems. So I knew my audio was working. I couldn't get any audio out of the card. I don't know what the hell was going on. The audio driver was there. It's picked up in control panel. Everything's there. But it is not distributing audio out of it at all. It doesn't appear in control panel. Doesn't appear anywhere. I don't know what the hell is going on. But it appears in device manager as it operating. And I'm like, okay. I restart the computer. I run DDU. Thank God we have that tool. If we didn't, man, that would be the end of my audio right there. And I uninstalled completely the driver set, reinstalled the drivers, and I'm back up and running. So total we have now is 12-core, 3.8 gigahertz Alienware, 40 gigs of RAM, a 1070 with one 2-terabyte mechanical, one 1-terabyte NVMe, and I will be adding way more glorious features to this machine upcoming. I have a PCI Express to NVMe adapter coming because I would like to add more hard drives to this thing, but remember, it's an Alienware case, so you're only limited to 3 hard drives. No offense here, Alienware, you absolutely suck dingus. Because if I want more than 3 hard drives, which I'm going to need for video editing and photo editing and things I do in my daily life, I'm pretty well up shit creek without a paddle, basically. Which does not help anyone. I want to thank you all for stopping by, though, for this video. It's been a fun, fun time trying to get this working. I hope this new microphone allows you to hear my video a little bit better. I am experimenting with a pile microphone, as you can see in my hand, and we are going to be trying a lot of new things. I do have an amplifier that also does plug into this. It's an RJ45 microphone, so it will plug into amplifiers and other things if I wanted to sing, dance, whatever on my channel. And yes, I can sing. Thank you. But, far from that. Enjoy. Have a lovely day. Remember, if you're currently out in the hot weather today, keep yourself cool, hydrated, and in the shade. Thank you all for stopping by, and have a lovely day.